Oh God, I'm about to cry already. Hold on. Okay, this is not gonna work. It's not gonna work. What's up, guys? Your girl Trend Lifestyle and Cut. What's up? Dang, no, you still can tell I was crying. What's up, guys? You got Trend Lifestyle and Cut. What's up? And I'm back with another video. The music is on. What the fuck?
Don't tell me I can't have it because I get it myself. Tryna set limits. I'm not with it. I'm the gold. I'm the best. Yeah.
Guys, your girl Trend Lifestyle Unica. What's up? And I am back with another video. As you could tell by the title, I've been contemplating on doing this video for a very long time. I'm actually re-recording it because I'm in a new setting. So I've sent this to a couple of my friends to see if I really wanted to do this. And I also sent it to my mom. Well, I didn't send all of it to my mom, but I sent her what I wanted her to know at the time. This is my pillow. I'm gonna start using a pillow in my videos. Anyway, I don't know why, I just want to. It's a letter to my actual dad stating how I feel, how I've been feeling for a very, 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 very long time. I may have some subscribers out there who doesn't have a dad, who grew up and still is growing up without a father, and I know how it feels, so you're not alone. I wrote it down in my notes. It is very, very long, but I'm gonna read it. It's very long because this is what, you know, I have to say. There's more, but after this, if you don't get how I'm feeling after this and out of this, then there's no need for me to keep trying. I'm not going to keep trying. I tried to reach out. I got a response, but it wasn't the response that I was looking for, that I wanted, you know? So, if you ever see this video, watching this video, the full entire video, then you get the message. I don't know if this video gonna be too long. It might not be that long. I might cry. I might not cry. I've been crying all day. I cried all day yesterday. Talked to my friends about it. I know that I'm gonna get feedback, positive, negative comments, but I don't care. I don't care. This is my way of getting closure. Your comments is not going to be anything. Well, it is, but I'm not going to. The negative comments, I'm not going to care because nobody's helping me. Nobody is going to ever be able to fill those shoes. So, me feeling the pain that I'm feeling, just be happy that I'm trying to share it with y'all, okay? 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 I'm not trying to make this video too long, though. I don't really want to go over 10 minutes, but if it goes over 10 minutes, then it goes over 10 minutes. So, I've been working on it all day. I worked on it yesterday. Like I said, I might cry. I might not cry. You see this shirt? Oh, if you see this shirt again, I'm recording multiple videos because I haven't dropped a video in about 4 weeks. because I've been working, but since we're going through whatever this crisis is, I've been quarantining in my room, contemplating what kind of videos I'm gonna do, and quarantining got me in my feelings, thinking about my biological father, okay? So, let's read the letter. I'm nervous. Again, I might cry, might not. Just depending on, yeah. So it starts by saying to my biological dad, hey, it's Trinity. Why am I doing this? Maybe for closure. Just 2 years ago in 2018, you told my mother to tell me that you didn't want nothing to do with me. Let's stop right there. Now, 2 years ago, I found a sister on my dad's side. Actually, she's the daughter who was born before me. I reached out to her, sent her a paragraph, sent her a picture, sent her the baby picture of me looking just like my biological dad. That's when he reached out to my mom on Facebook and messaged her saying how he doesn't want nothing to tell Trinity that he doesn't want nothing to do with her. Like, we don't want nothing to do with her at all. That wasn't the response that I wanted. I'm thinking I'm going to get answers. No, that wasn't the case at all. I mean, I didn't expect him to be like, oh yeah, okay, now that she knows, they know, let's be a family. No, I wasn't expecting that at all. But anyway, back to the letter. It say, after many, many years of trying to reach out to you, all I ever did was get ignored. For what my mom told me was you were around, but I don't ever remember seeing your face. Growing up, I always felt unwanted simply because my own dad didn't want to be around me or get to at least know me. Y'all read this like I'm in class. Where am I? Oh, I used to always feel alone and left out because I didn't have a dad. Yeah, I have brothers, but it's not the same as having the father-daughter relationship and bond. Growing up, it was hard. All my friends had their dads. Even now today, my friends have their dads. I can connect with two of my friends because they are going through something similar than what I'm going through. I'm not going to tell you guys their names, but just know I have two friends that I can connect to, and trust me, I went straight to them about how I was feeling. I can connect with two of my friends because they're going through something similar to me, except you never actually took the time to know me. And I look at my friends and their dad and always wish that could have been us. Y'all, I'm getting the waterworks, but I'm tired of crying. My eyes hurt, you know. And that's why I'm laughing and joking about it right now, because I'm not trying to cry. I don't want to cry. This. I don't want to cry. Okay, y'all, I don't want to cry. Okay, next one is, I always question myself, why wasn't I good enough? I asked my mom, did anything ever happen between y'all? She told me no. So you basically decided to stop coming and leave. My mom got married to a guy, which she did for a long time. I don't remember the year, but it was a long time. So they were married for a long time. I didn't like him for real. I tolerated him. I never called him dad simply because I thought that you would come back to be a father to me. Tricky. I grew up in life low-key not liking myself. My mom has never known this, but she's finding out now. Now, this is the part that I sent her. And my mom was like, what's this? Who wrote this? I'm like, me. I'm like, B, I wrote it. She's like, why, what's wrong? I'm like, I just want closure, you know? I'm writing this to him. Trust me, I'm gonna post this video and I'm gonna send him this video on Facebook. I have his Facebook. So, when I say I tried to reach out, I've tried to reach out, okay? Out of all of my friends in my life, childhood to now, I've always been the good friend, the goofy friend, the funny friend, the comedian, making everyone laugh. But deep down inside, I've been upset because I felt unwanted by someone who helped create me. I didn't ask to be here, but I'm here. I barely made it, but I'm here. When I say I barely made it, I was preemie. I was 1 pound. So, yes, I was 1 pound and I made it up out of there. I left Memorial Day and my granny threw me a party. Who you know? Get a party thrown for a preemie coming home. Period. Anyway, and I said I barely made it. I almost died last year, but I'm here. I never been to a daddy-daughter dance. I never got the chance to do the father-daughter things. I felt abandoned by you. People always ask me, what do I ever have to be sad about? Your mom give you everything you want and need. And it's true. A lot of people say, you're so spoiled. You have everything you want. Yeah, but my mom can't be a father, you know? It's so much that a parent could do. A single mother at that. So, even when my mom was married, I wouldn't say I didn't have a dad. I mean, she was married. It's like he tolerated us. That's how I feel. Like, he did stuff with the boys and not really much me, you know? He played games with my little brother. He did basketball with my big brother until they fell out. So I was just there. I always wanted to be around my mom. It was like I was just always there. You know, yeah. It's like he was connected with them more than me. I didn't really too much care for it because I always thought my dad would come back. So I would, you know. Yeah. Where am I? I said, yeah. Oh, I'm at, yes, she did. But my mom can't be a father. She can't fill in those shoes. It's something about a girl having that relationship with their father. But you will never understand how I feel. You had a kid in 98, told my mother that you and her mother were no longer together. Whole time, he has a whole family that supposedly he wasn't dealing with anymore. Whatever you want to call it. And I said later on in 2000, I came and you left. So yeah. I used to cry myself to sleep all the time. My mother also never knew that. I remember there was a time I told my uncle that I hated you so much that if you were to die today, I wouldn't even feel nothing. I wouldn't care because I don't know you. I saw one picture. I don't even know where that picture is. I saw one picture of you. My mama told me that when I was in the seventh grade, before we moved here. We moved here, what, I think it's 2014, I think. Let me see. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Yeah, we moved here in 2014. Yeah, I was in 7th grade. Before moving to North Carolina, she told you that we were moving and you said that you were going to come see me. And guess what? You never came. I didn't expect for you to come because that's what you are good at. Never showing up. Don't show up and don't show out. So, you know, I'm kind of used to stuff coming in and out, you know? It's like in and out. Y'all, I'm not crying. I'm doing good. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And this is the last part. I forgive you, but I will never forget. I'm washing my hands with this whole situation, and I'm washing my hands with you. And that's all I got to say. If you didn't get anything out of that, then I don't know what to tell you. I'm done trying. I'm not going to keep, you know, I'm done. I'm not going to keep reaching out. It is what it is. It is what it is. There you go. It is what it is. And you know, to all the girls out there who doesn't have a father in their life, it's okay. It's okay. Because one day when you get older, they're going to regret it. You're going to become something big in life, and they're going to be trying to come into your life once they realize that they messed up. Think about that. If I take off on this YouTube stuff, I guarantee you, once I come across his timeline again, he's going to try, and I'm going to shut him down, because you had the chance many, many years ago. Guys, my birthday is next week. I'm going to be 20. I don't have time for that no more. This is the closure that I'm getting, and this is how I'm going to reach out to you. If you see this video, you see it. If you don't, then I don't care. As long as I said what I said and got it off my chest, I'm done. It's over, and I'm straight. Now, my mama was dealing with this guy for a long time. Since we moved here, they broke up, and it's fine. Did I call him dad? Yes, you guys saw that. I called him dad, and they broke up, and we barely talk now. So, it is what it is. It is what it is. But yeah, it is what it is. And once again, to all the girls out there who doesn't have a dad, keep your head up. It hurts a lot, very much. It hurt a lot, but it's going to be okay. You got to keep your head up. As long as you have your mother or brother, even though that's not the relationship that you want. Hey, I have 5 brothers. Well, I'm including my god brothers, if you want to say that. I have 6. And they are, I'm blessed to have all of them in my life. Torny, I love you. You are very missed. That's one of my brothers who passed away. If you didn't know, now you know. So, it's okay. Life is going to get hard, but it's okay. You got it. And if you like this video, even though, you know, it's towards my dad, like, comment, subscribe, turn on your post notification, hit that thumbs up button, and comment down below any videos that you guys want to see. I'm really trying to take this YouTube stuff serious, but my mind doesn't want me to be creative. But since we're in quarantine, I'm going to try to do my best before we can't even leave the house. So, yes, if you like this video, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, turn on your post notification. Hit the bell so you can catch my next upload. You guys may see this video. You guys may see 2 videos tomorrow. I'm not sure. But thanks for listening to me rant about my sperm donor. I love you guys. This will be on the last night. Prayed on a falling star. Falling star. That you never had a broken heart. Broken heart. The world is cold. Just remember who you are. What was possible was impossible. Made my own way, doing everything they said not to do. Still testing the waters while overcoming every obstacle. I put God first and trusted my gut and started making moves. This chestnut checkers, every move is strategic. Had some ups and had some downs, but it brought strength to my weakness. I was lost and now I'm found. They tried to keep me a secret, but what's in the dark comes to the light. But